My name is Lyric Williams. I attended Armstrong High School. I play the wing, so versatile. I play 1, 2, and 3. My favorite player is Candace Parker, and I will be attending Johnson County Community College.
My name is Sydney Starling. I'm a point guard. I went to Thomas Jefferson High School. I'm going to San Francisco State University, and my favorite player is Steph Curry.
I'm Kenda Zellner-Smith. I'm 18. I went to Washburn High School. I was a powered forward, and I'm going to the University of Milwaukee, and my favorite player is Maya Moore.
Kyla Adams. My position is a power forward. The college I'm attending is North Dakota State School of Science, and my favorite player is Stephen Curry.
My name is Curtisa Scott. I went to Johnson High School, and I was a point guard. I'm going to University of Nebraska, Omaha, and my favorite player is Rajon Rondo.
Daria Lipscomb, guard at Patrick Union High School. Anoka Ramsey, favorite player, Candace Parker.
My name is Kaylee Adams. I went to Richfield. My favorite player is Kevin Durant. I will be attending North Dakota State of Science, and any positions I play all.
I'm Raven Dubois. I go to Breck School. My favorite player is Kyrie Irving. I'm going to Savannah College of Art and Design, and I'm like a 2-3 shooting guard.
I'm Lexi Lee. I'm a shooting guard or point guard. I go to Maranatha Christian Academy, and next year I'm going to Sioux Falls, and my favorite player is Stephen Curry.
Chelsea Kizart, my high school, St. Paul Central. My college, Cloud County Community College. My position, point guard. My favorite player, Klay Thompson.
Taylor Toney, De La Salle High School. I'll be attending UIC, University of Illinois at Chicago. I play small forward, and my favorite player is Kevin Durant.
My name is Olivia. My high school is St. Paul Central. My college is undecided. My position is shooting guard, and my favorite player is Stephen Curry.
My name is Lexis Hughes. I'm from South High School. I am a small forward. I am undecided, and my favorite basketball player is Kevin Durant.
I'm Lauren Smith from Johnson High School. I'm a point guard, and I'm going to Iowa Lakes Community College, and my favorite player is Kevin Durant.
Hey, how's it going, Troy? Are you ready for the exciting game today? The game is about to begin, and we're trying to get things going here. We got Team Faith versus Team Truth today in the house, in the building. Welcome to 2015 Intercity All-Star Classic All-Star Game. This is our first part of that. This will be the girls' game, and we're excited to get things started. I'm with the host of the most, Troy.
How you doing today, Faith? I was confused on if we were actually on air or not, but I believe so. We have a foul to start the ball game. What you think is going to happen today with these young ladies? You know, there isn't that star power quote that we've had in the past, so it should be a very competitive game. What you think?
Well, absolutely. You know what's really interesting? We've got Lexi Lee, who is here today with us. She is an amazing player. I've watched her play. She played in the state tournament a few years. That would be my choice today for the MVP.
But that was Chelsea Kizart just made a layup there.
So we've got
Faith.
Taylor Toney, De La Salle. She's a Division I prospect.
Really? Okay.
There's quite a few girls out there. And I was talking to you earlier. It's so amazing each year the amount of talent that the state of Minnesota continues to develop. And I had mentioned to you before that there are a lot of these girls that are from different schools that we don't kind of normally see, which says a lot for girls basketball in the state of Minnesota.
Exactly. Lyric Williams is at the line for Team Truth, shooting 2 free throws. Lyric played for Armstrong this past season.
And I'm excited, behind us today, we've got Tamara Moore, who the trophy will be named after, or has been named after. She's in the building with us. Her and Maya Johnson, who two awesome players. There was a move right there.
Lyric Williams with the ball again to the basket.
She's actually pretty strong and pretty tough. Nice little hook shot. Wow.
Kyla Adams now with the ball. She's
Nyla is playing for Team Faith.
And she's a twin. There. She played for Richfield this year. Their team made it to the state tournament.
Yeah, they had a good run at the end of the year there, didn't they?
Oh, yeah.
Really good run.
Yeah, those are very powerful players. They can shoot the three, drive.
Nice
very
steal
physical.
By Zellner Smith. Yeah. Oh, see, that was my confusion. They're twins, so I was confused.
That's
thank
a
you for
nice
telling me
layup.
That, I was really confused.
Attempt there.
Chelsea Kizard is at the line shooting two.
From Central, I watched her play this year. She is quick.
Yeah, she looks
what
like
a defender.
She has a nice free throw stroke, too.
Nice you don't shot. See too many lefties anymore. I mean, I always admired the left-hand shooter. They just said, seems like they got such great form.
They do. It looks. Either they're great, great shooters or they're really bad shooters, like they're not in between. Yeah.
And someone like her, you know, I think a lot of people sometimes, you know, go against the community colleges or junior colleges, but see there she's going to a community college in St. Cloud.
Okay.
For players that are haven't really had an opportunity to get exposure, oftentimes that's a great situation for
great
them to be able to,
yeah.
to get seen.
Exactly.
But she's quite so a good. Look at the handles. Oh, my
for
God.
For three.
Unbelievable handles right there. Larry Williams and Armstrong at the ball hand. She's quite the athlete. I mean, I haven't seen Armstrong play at all this year, but I mean, she's got great handles. She's left and right hook shot. She's driving to the basket. Looked like she has the capability of bringing the ball up right now to play the point position. I mean, look at the
shoot
handles
the
there
again.
In the pull up.
Oh, Lyric Williams.
Lyric Williams.
She's coming
from
out for
Armstrong.
She's coming out for the MVP right away. Oh, that's always fun in this game to really see like who's gonna take home that trophy. Because they really go after that award.
Oh, yeah, these guys are serious.
Kids
there's
are right
my lefty
back.
Right there. Look at them. And that's what I'm talking about, the strength there. The twin from, I'm going to call her the twin. The twin
so
from
that was,
Richfield.
So that must be Kayla. So Kayla, okay, we got Kyla and Kayla. We're on the wrong team. So Kayla is on Team Truth. And Kyla is on Team Faith.
I'm surprised that they took twins and split.
I think. Yeah, they should have been on the same team. Made it easy for us.
That's probably the same. That's probably the first time they've actually been split.
And they both are wearing 22, so that's not making it easy for me at all. Miss Kizart with the ball up top.
Send the highest screen, open. The lefty.
Oh, nice steal.
Oh,
there.
The defense. By
that's
number
Curtessa,
11.
Curtessa Scott, our
from Johnson, and the rebound once again.
Uh-oh.
Lyric Williams.
Lyric going to work. Curtessa Scott won the Kwame McDonald GPA Award this year.
Wow, that's impressive.
3.9 GPA.
Unbelievable. I don't even know what that looks like.
I know. I know what a 9 looks like, but it comes usually a 1 comes before mine.
When I was in high school, the 2-point something was popular, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I just kind of went with the popular grades at that time, you know?
Seriously. You know, make life easier for yourself. To the basket.
Oh, with the Michael Jordan move.
One of the Adams girls
little
to the
short.
Basket.
Nice pass.
Oh, Williams to the basket again. Oh, Lyric Williams.
Lyric Williams
Lyric
is
Williams.
On a mission.
She's getting buckets, that's for sure.
She is on a mission.
What, she got all 6?
I believe so. She has all 6 points. She came, she understood, she's been watching the All-Star Classic for a number of years. She said, you know what? I got next.
I'm ready to go. It's my turn. Kizart with the ball up top. Over to Lexi Lee.
She looks like she won a pull. She's got the range. Nice
no
look
pass.
Pass.
Oh, she got fouled.
From
wow.
Lexi Lee with a nice no look pass. Kind of put you in mind of JP McCure of last year. Remember?
Yeah, exactly.
What a player.
Lexis Hughes is going to the line. No, they caught it on the floor. They got some subs coming in here for Team Faith as Lauren Smith. And for Team Truth, we have Emma Shepherd.
Taylor Toney for 3.
Oh, a little short.
Played for Mia De La Salle.
Miss Adams cannot catch up with the ball. Be a turnover.
Taylor Toney's got quite the potential, I tell you. Number five, it just shot the three there. She can shoot the ball, she can bring it up, she can post it in the inside. She got a nice little pull-up inside, so I'm looking for her to have to play well, you know, this later half of the first half here.
Well, we got Lexi Lee now with the ball from Maranatha. They've been, had a little dynasty there on Miss Adams, but still, Kylie or Kayla. And she scores.
We may need a timeout, baby.
Eight to three. Nice pass.
Right there. Lexi Lee with the assist.
Toney Taylor with the finish.
It's Taylor Toney, but it's okay.
Oh, it's Taylor Toney?
Her sister. I don't know. I don't know if you can call it amongst twins. That's just how they normally play.
She fouled her sister.
She said she's not going to let it. That must be the older twin.
She
ain't going to let the younger sister score on her.
All of 2 minutes older or whatever it be.
They're actually very good athletes. They're going to, I believe, the North Dakota College of Science.
Okay.
In North Dakota.
North Dakota.
They've produced a lot of Division I athletes. I've had a couple of kids attending that college there.
And it's 9-5, pretty tight beginning of the game. Lauren Smith from Johnson to the basket, turns it over. No, she does not. Controls the ball. First three.
Lexi Lee. Oh. I told you she's got range, but not right now. The steal and the finish.
Finish by Lauren Smith.
Team Faith has the faith.
Yeah, they do. Team Faith is still down three right now to Team Truth.
We talked about this earlier. I really believe, no one's told me this and confirmed it, I really believe Team Faith was named after Baby
Bunny. I believe so, too. I believe that's true.
But that has not been...
That hasn't been confirmed?
That hasn't been confirmed.
Are you sure?
The twins going to work.
Uh-oh.
Taylor Toney takes it from her.
Into the basket. Whoa, nice
no-look. No-look pass from Taylor Toney.
Shot's no good.
Lexi Lee. Nice pass.
Well, we have two number fives on the court. That's a lead on Curtis Evans.
Going in strong.
Oh, and she finishes.
Get out of her way. She is the truth.
Yep, no doubt. Taylor Toney finishes with the left hand.
From De La Salle, the Islander.
De La Salle.
That's what I'm talking about. The Islanders represent, represent.
The only island school in Minneapolis. Adams to the basket.
And she's
stripped by Taylor.
Taylor Toney once again. She is on to her.
Oh, and there's a foul.
Nice pass.
Curtis Evans is fouled.
The nice no-look pass.
Going to the line, shooting two.
Team Faith is playing some ball. They're coming back. They're putting it on them. We got some famous people in the building.
Famous.
Coming over to say hi, share the love.
Share the love. More subs coming in the ball game here. Lyric Williams had a hard start. She's coming back in the game right now. Sydney Starling checking in the game.
There's so many subs going on. I can't even keep up with
Aaliyah Curtis Evans at the line shooting two. Nice rebound.
Offensive rebound. But the defense, did you see that block?
Lexis Hughes got the rebound and got her shot blocked by Emma Shepherd.
She looked at that like, not here today.
Yeah, Emma Shepherd out of Washburn.
Oh, nice reverse.
To the basket. Nice.
Nice
move.
She
finished. Lucia Renikoff.
Oh, my God.
She was a Minneapolis Conference Player of the Year this year out of Washburn.
I can see why. Very impressive move, just a little short on the finish. A nice pass by the other twin.
No, that was Raven Dubois.
The pass from the twin was amazing.
It was. Oh, the pass. Oh, yeah, the pass. I thought you were talking about the bucket. The pass was definitely, uh-oh.
Lyric Williams onto the ground. She's on the ground.
Uh-oh. Timeout.
Timeout.
By the new Minneapolis Sports coach, Crystal Flint.
Crystal Flint on top of it. No, you know, she's serious. She's not playing around. She called a timeout. She, you know.
This is her high school coaching debut.
Is this practice for the real deal?
For the real deal, yes. Crystal, an alumni of former Golden Gopher basketball player.
And we were teammates. We were teammates playing for Pro-Am League, Howard Pulley, when they had the girls back then playing.
Oh, yep. Summit, was that with the Summit University Stars, or was that after that?
No, that was after that. That was the Howard Pulley.
Oh, the girl, I know some of the Pro-Am League.
Yeah. I like to consider myself a professional. I was playing in the Pro-Am League.
Oh, yeah, you definitely would have been a pro if they had the pros back when you played.
Okay,
no doubt
now you're
that.
Aging me, Troy. Okay.
Well, I'm just saying, you know,
it's wavy in the building.
We know you would have been a WNBA player if they had WNBA back then. Now, were you back with the Phillies? No, you weren't enough to play with the Phillies,
right? I wasn't
enough
to play with the Phillies, but I was watching them. I was playing basketball when they were playing here from Minnesota. They were quite
See,
the
so
team.
You weren't old enough to play for the Phillies, and then you were too old to play for the Lakes. So you just got screwed all the way around with the whole pro thing.
And that's why women's basketball is such a great time to be a female basketball player.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Intercity All-Star Classic has grown tremendously. Yep. And now pretty much, I mean, it used to be kind of hard to find athletes. Now it's a privilege and an honor to be placed on a team. Raven DuBois with the short
on the shot.
But it was a nice, impressive move. Nice, impressive.
The Bird, the on-court commentator. Uh-oh, shot fake.
Oh.
And the finish. Woo. Kylie Ortega
with the up
Adams.
Fake. The up fake and fade away to the left. Nice shot.
Nice
She's
shot.
Ready now.
Lyric Williams.
Lyric Williams with the shake and the fade
away. That goes
away.
In. Oh, it did not go in. That would have been nice.
I think she's been watching Stephen Curry.
Heck yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
I can't wait to get home to watch that.
With the shot in the corner.
Kisser.
Okay. Nice catch by the chair.
They are working hard. You know, this is supposed to be an all-star game, and they're playing hard like it's a regular season game, and that's always fun to watch.
And, you know, that's the difference, I think, with girls and the guys.
No doubt.
You know, they go at it.
No doubt.
You know, and they're out here playing ball.
No doubt.
They don't want to leave. They're extremely competitive.
Yeah, they're not out here just to, you know, dunk and get oohs and ahs. They're out here competing, so. Miss Kizart with the ball. Right by, but she got her shot blocked for the foul. She blew right by Lucia Rinnicall.
That kid is quick. She is quick.
And she's at the line shooting two. Missed the first free throw. The score is 13-12 in favor of Team Faith, has taken the lead.
Gotta have faith.
Gotta have it. Truth don't never hurt either, though.
I love that shot, I tell you. Kizzard, what a great shooter. Great free throw shooter.
Yep. Uh-oh.
Lyric Williams. Once again, going to work.
Oh, look, there was a foul there with the Adams.
Taylor Toney is all over her. She can't get to the basket. It's almost like she's got her number.
She is. Taylor Toney looks like a very versatile player. She has a length to play a number of different positions.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Can't wait to be excited to watch her play at the next level.
Nice pass
by Lexi Lee. And the finish by
Kizart. Chelsea Kizart out of Central. St. Paul Central. Oh.
The D by Lexi Lee.
Lexi Lee is just playing some fabulous defense
out
there.
She gets double teamed. Held on to it.
They are playing some awesome, awesome defense out there.
That was pretty surprising. It was pretty, pretty exciting. Nice pass.
Kizart ahead. Raven DuBois to the basket. Oh, she's fouled. She will be shooting two.
She had a
Raven
great,
out of Breck.
Yeah, she had a
Breck
great career
school,
out of Breck. I mean, I tell you, we played against those guys there in our conference. We're in a conference, so they kind of revitalized things. But we had sometimes put two and three people on her.
Mm-hmm.
She likes to slither through people. Looks like she's a little rusty. You know, somebody goes, you know, haven't really been playing a lot.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is a good test for them.
So yep.
And an awakening for them to say, hey, listen, I need to get back in shape. Or
now, did she just shoot each free throw with the opposite hand? Did she one with the left and the one with
yes,
the right and make them both?
So I said she's very skilled.
That was, I thought I saw that.
Oh, what a move. What a move.
Nice play.
That was Kayla Adams.
Uh-oh, turnover. Uh-oh, Lyric with the ball again.
Lyric wins. But Kayla, the finger roll.
Oh.
She got it back. Nice save right there.
There is some hard play going on right now, Mr.
Coach,
I'm telling
awesome
you, they're
playing. Offensive rebounds, right in a row.
Yeah, this young man, Jalen Suggs, just walked in front of us. Going to definitely be the next future star out of Minnesota.
Another sub. I know he's got to be
related
to.
He's the number one rated seventh grader in the country.
He's a seventh grader. That's the kid that's going to.
Yeah, he's going to be in eighth grade next year.
At Minnehaha, correct?
Minnehaha Academy.
I've heard about him.
Yeah. He's special.
Wow.
Played varsity as a seventh grader last year.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wow, and he's got some height to him as well.
Yeah, man, he's already about 6 feet tall.
Wow.
That Suggs gene is pretty strong.
They got a young female Suggs over at Hopkins. She'll be here in 2 years.
You know, there's a few families. You know, you got the Johnsons. You got the Taylors and
nice
the Suggs.
Shot.
You know, you got a few, you know, those three families there, man. How to combine and make a super kid.
That was Lauren Smith and Johnson with the three.
Lucia, nice.
Taylor Toney got pushed.
She got pushed.
Kayla Adams said, no more. I'm tired of you stealing the ball from me.
She's a strong girl. Checking in for Team Truth, number 42 is Kendra Zellner Smith out of Washburn High School.
Where did they come up with the ideas and the theme for each year, the colors of the uniforms? I really love
you
this.
You know, Derek, Mr. Derek Rubin, who is the CEO, and this is, you know, the when it started the game here, he also has a clothing line, so I believe that him and his brother, Dwayne Rubin, come up with these colors every year.
Wow. Very impressive.
Very impressive.
Taylor Toney.
Nice
like I
shot.
Said,
nice
with
shot.
With the fadeaway.
With the elevation, too. She was high over the defense with that shot.
I got to show a little love for my one of my athletes.
Yourself.
Kayla Adams with the three.
Nice
short
block out
rebound
there
by Taylor Toney. Brings the ball up. She's showing her versatility with the no-look pass
shot
to Kayla.
Oh.
Adams. Her sister Kayla with the rebound. She looks to slow it up.
50 seconds left to go in the half. Very quick first
half. Unbelievable. I cannot believe. She drives once again on Taylor Toney.
Oh,
Taylor,
they didn't go out of bounds.
Got a rebound. Taylor's all over it. Third time in a row. Give it to her.
Now the foul's called.
What defense by Taylor Toney. She is relentless when it comes to stopping Kayla Adams. Unbelievable.
But they gave the foul was on her. Not that anybody keeps track of foul.
Well,
I don't think anybody fouled out her in her city all-star class.
Those two played together years ago for an AU program called Charity Warriors.
Oh, wow, yeah.
And so they're really good friends.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, which is really good to be, you know, competitive and be friends still.
Charity Warriors, isn't that Patrick Adams' program?
Oh, yeah. Patrick Adams. He was just in the building saying hi. Him and his daughters up and coming. There'll be one of his daughters, Andrea, for sure will be here next year.
Yeah, Division One prospect.
Nice.
Oh,
pass.
That should have been an and one.
Oh,
where's
my goodness.
The foul? Where's the
Look
foul?
Look at that. The three by Kayla. Short. The block. The defense
25
unbelievable.
25 seconds left to go. Team Faith is up by six.
Dario, this come from Henry. Will it go?
Almost went in.
They're fighting over it.
About 10 seconds left to go.
Kayla Adams is going to pull for three.
From long way.
Just shy. There's still 6 seconds. Five. Her sister gets a chance to shoot the three. And
and it goes.
That's what twins are all about. One doesn't get it done, the other one does. Unbelievable.
And your halftime score is Team Faith 23,
What an exciting half.
19.
Wow.
What an exciting half.
Unbelievable.
We have the skills competition coming up at halftime. And I'm not sure what that consists of.
That was a repeat right there with her sister giving her credit. She hitting that three. Team Faith leads it 23-19.
23-19. So what'd you think about that half?
Well, I tell you, it was surprising. I mean, I was so surprised. But, you know, to be a low-scoring game, the competitiveness is just, I mean, they're going at it. I mean, mm-hmm. It's exciting.
Yeah.
And that's what I like, you know. A lot of these girls haven't had a lot of exposure and have the opportunity for people to know and see who they are. And so, you know, they're making some noise here.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah.
exciting.
Yeah. And basically what I'm seeing is how hard they are playing, as if it's right. a regular game and not an all-star game. They're treating it as if, you know, this is their school game, you
yeah.
know, and they're out here competing and playing the game the right way, sharing the ball and playing good defense. So it's been fun.
It's been exciting.
Been fun to watch.
Good for those guys.
So they got a skills company. Look, they're going to have a tire. Brooke. That's Raven's mother. Raven Dubois' mother, I believe.
And her grandparents.
And her grandparents, yeah.
Every year this gets exciting. That's what I'm saying. You know, you're doing different things to, you know, make it more fun and exciting, especially for the girls, because, you know, the boys usually have a dunk contest, and so mm-hmm. for the girls it's exciting to mix it up and do some things other than the three-point shooting contest.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, the
exactly.
versatility and the creativity for young women these days it's pretty high level.
So involved in the skills competition for girls, we have Lexi Lee from Maranatha. We also have Sydney Starling from Jefferson, Curtessa Scott from Johnson, Aaliyah Curtis-Evans from Central, Lyric Williams from Armstrong, and Chelsea Kizart from Central. That is your skills competition competitors.
That's gonna be exciting.
It's gonna get started here shortly. You know, it's first year in a while we haven't had the game on Father's Day. So it's
yeah.
been able to, you know, gonna be able to free everyone up for their for
are
their
you,
weekend fun.
Are you excited
week.
About that? So you'll be able to spend time with your children?
Well, you know, my kids are all, you know, old now, teenagers. They don't care. You know, when the kids get to be teenagers, it's like, whatever, Dad. So teenagers are off to college. But I'm excited to have some time to my, you know, on Father's Day, you can choose to do what you want. You know, you can go hang out by yourself. And
yeah.
So that's Janae Morton, All-Star alumni.
She's, I believe, at Eastern Michigan.
Eastern Michigan, okay. Averaging almost 13 points a game over there, so doing
yeah,
pretty well.
Great job. Great career.
Yeah, good job.
Kenesha Bell, who actually will be, is transferred here. She was at Marquette last year. She's actually going to be a Gopher.
Oh, she
so
is.
So she'll be sitting out this next year coming up, and we'll be looking forward to having her back at home, which will be exciting. Play along
wow.
with Lena Stock.
So she averaged almost 15 points a game with the Marquette team last year in the Big East. So that's having one heck of a season.
11th in the Big Ten, Big East Conference, which is huge.
Wow. So a year from now.
My favorite, my niece.
That's your niece.
Tyshawna Johnson.
That is. That's another Johnson.
That's right. Her brother, Jarvis Johnson, will be playing here next game for the boys.
Yeah.
But she led the Big 12 Conference in rebounds.
Okay.
And five rebounds away from passing Megan Taylor in Iowa State career, her record. And she's just going to be a junior. That's unbelievable.
Wow.
So she almost averaged a double-double.
Almost, wow.
So that's exciting.
That
I mean,
exciting.
I feel pretty proud about that.
That
and
is
I see
exciting.
You see Jarvis Johnson coming in now with the hat.
Yeah.
Her brother
mm-hmm.
walking in the building. And
so they're
there he is right there, Jarvis Johnson with the hat.
Jarvis Johnson, we play it in the next
that's
game.
That's the new look, I guess, or whatever, you
well,
know?
That's, it's new for the teenagers because I have a whole bunch of them in my closet. But we're older, old
there's
guys.
There's my two brothers, there's Anthony, and yeah.
yeah,
there's a Johnson clan you just talked about.
Yeah, that's some of those Johnson jeans, and too many of you guys running around here with basketball.
There's more Johnsons
I've never
behind
met,
me.
I've never met a Johnson that wasn't outstanding at basketball, and I'm trying to figure out how that's possible.
Yeah, it's gonna be it's interesting.
Seems like somebody should have chosen a different sport, but all of them are basketball stars.
Well, he's going to be playing for the Gophers.
Playing
so
for the Gophers.
We're excited about that.
I'm excited about someone from here finally, one of our big time high school athletes finally staying home and on the men's side.
Yeah.
You know, we had Tyus Lee last year. And
Reed Travis
left last year, and you know, a lot of the guys, and so to get someone to stick around, pretty exciting.
JP McCurry. There's Larry McKenzie in the building.
Yep,
his bride.
Hi.
Exciting.
Larry McKenzie, coach at Minneapolis North
and
High
that's
School.
And that's what I, you know, that's the whole thing. It's so exciting. There's so many people that come out to this event, you know? A lot of popular people, Tamara Moore in the house, and, you know, it's just, what an event. I mean, how many years has this been now since the InterCity All-Star Classic has been in existence?
It is 22 years.
Unbelievable.
This is our 22nd annual InterCity All-Star Classic. We've been at this for a while.
That's amazing.
So
that is absolutely amazing.
You know, I remember in the sweatbox gyms we used to compete in back at Minneapolis Central Gym back in the day, and we were at Minneapolis North. We've been at St. Paul Arlington. We've been at, we've been at Concordia in St. Paul. So we, you know, no matter what gym, we've been consistent in bringing you the.
Well, we're kind of catching back up with the skills drill here. This looks very difficult, by the way.
Yeah, getting it through this tire I saw was an issue for some of them, but
I hope they have enough energy to finish the second half. These girls are working hard. You can see they got to make a layup, and then they've got to do a dribbling between the chairs here, and then they've got to put the ball through the tire, and then finish with the opposite hand, and then it looks like they got to come back down. Unbelievable. And make a free throw. Wow.
Oh, she made it look easy.
That was impressive.
She made it look very, very easy.
You've got to be in shape to do that, by the way.
That is awesome. That was Sydney Starling from Jefferson who made that. Ooh. Now looks like we have Curtessa Scott from Johnson.
She can't get it through. But she's pretty fast. She's pretty fast. She put this in. She can tie, I believe, with 22.9 seconds.
She can make it in this free throw here.
Wow.
Oh, 23.4.
Just 0.4 or 5 seconds
If she hadn't missed just putting the ball through that tire, she would have beat it easy.
Now, this is one of my favorites, Lyric Williams from Armstrong. She's been very impressive today.
Here she goes.
I'm very excited to see what she has to bring to the table right here.
Here she goes.
This kid is quick, and I love how she puts the ball down in front of her, catches up to it. She is extremely fast. Nice ball. You can tell she's been doing this stuff for a while. That's my winner right here, I'm telling you, with the finger roll. Unbelievable. If she can make this free throw here. Wow,
oh,
my God, 20
seconds.
20.4.
Wow,
unbelievable.
I think she's going to win everything today. She's going to win MVP. She's going to win this thing.
Look.
She's just going to walk away home with all the trophies.
Hey, this kid looks like she could be playing for the Gophers next year. Unbelievable. Where is she going to school? Does it say on here where she's going to college? I'll be the first person to advocate on her behalf.
Yeah.
What a player.
What a player, yes, she is. She's long and athletic. Long
and
arms.
Can handle the basketball.
Handle the basketball.
Wow, very impressive.
And she has won the skills competition.
And I also believe that she might be a good candidate for the All-Star game as well if her team continues to
definitely
play
for
basketball.
All-Star MVP. I mean, she's
between her and the and Kayla Adams.
And one of the Adams girls,
They're playing tough.
College she's going to is Johnson County. Matter of fact, yeah, her dad told me about that. She's going to Johnson County.
I'm going to have to keep up with her.
And then he said that she's probably going to be going to, hopefully, Virginia afterwards.
Wow. Yeah.
When that came on screen, that conversation popped back in my head. You know, I'm getting old, so I'm
she's quite
things.
The athlete. I can see
but
that.
Yeah.
She's quick.
Yeah.
And she can shoot it. She can drive to the basket and handle the ball. Yeah.
Johnson County Community College. It's in Kansas.
It's one of the better junior colleges.
Division
programs.
One junior college, yep. Yeah, so get scholarship country. Money to go there.
So, good for her. That's exciting. Mm-hmm. Maybe we can get her back here as well to play for the Gophers.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, once she's at junior college, I mean, if she's fair game.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to be advocating on her behalf for Minnesota. So I'm going to reach out to the Gopher coaches and say, hey, you want to be on the lookout for Lyric Williams, quite the athlete. Crystal Taylor will be assisting Crystal Flint, one of my former athletes at Minneapolis North. The new head coach at Minneapolis North. I want to send her a shout out and congratulate her. I have passed on the torch to her. I'm excited about that. I can finally wear the black and gold and not think about the royal blue. Now that it's being in good hands, I'm excited about that. Congratulations, Crystal.
Yep, that's awesome. You know, I think that they are, you know, if they can continue this to, you know, do what the boys did and get the athletes in, you know, the coaching will be there.
Another great coach, Tanisha Scott. You know, I don't know if many people have had an opportunity to see her. She's a very good X and O coach. I coached her last year for a semi-professional team, and she played the point guard position. Not a lot of knowledge, high basketball IQ, and man, she's going to do good things. She's got Taylor Hill's younger sister playing for her, Morgan Hill at South. Be exciting to watch her grow and flourish under her sister, Tanisha Scott.
Yeah, like I was, you know, I was saying, I think I said the Taylors, I meant the Hills. You know, it's just, you know, like you said, there is just athlete after athlete. Second half has started. Sydney Starling with the pass. Oh, ball stolen.
Derrick Williams on the ground, picks it up.
Ball's kicked.
They're fighting for it, the Twins. Unbelievable. They're starting off again the same way they started before. The boys look like they're walking in, getting ready. Put it down. Looks like this is going to be an exciting game next game.
Kizart with the ball. Kizart to the back. Oh! Shot blocked. Mr. Adams with the ball.
Larry Williams with the shot. Drove baseline. Rebound. Daria Lipscomb. Do you know that she averaged over 20 rebounds a game for Henry? Daria Lipscomb, right here, number 5.
That is amazing.
She averaged a double-double.
20 rebounds?
Yes.
So she must have led the state in rebounding.
Absolutely.
Well, that's awesome.
What a great player. She also played for Cherry Warriors. Started out playing for me at De La Salle. And wanted to go back and finish up her career. She wanted to play for a public school.
Yep.
A good look there, Taylor Toney. As my favorite point guard brings it up.
She is really doing a good job with Team Faith running the point.
Raven DuBois with the miss. Once again, the rebound.
Rebound. She has a neck for
no getting surprise.
The rebound.
Daria Lipscomb.
Coast to coast.
Daria Lipscomb. Coast to coast. Off the rebound. Coast to coast from the chair, representing the Cherry World. Oh my God. Did you see the move?
What a
unbelievable.
Move.
I think they saw the boys walk in and said, hey, you know,
Lipscomb,
you're not going to take all the attention from me. Nice no-look pass to Taylor Toney. That was a great look. You got to give it credit. It was a great look. But, you know, as soon as the boys got, I noticed that the pace
picked
the intensity
up a
picked
bit.
Up. The girls are like, hey, look, we're playing right now.
We're playing right now. We'll be trying to steal our show.
Wow, unbelievable. Great game. What a great game.
Lyric Williams with the ball.
Lyric Williams looks like she's going to the basket. I already knew it.
And she finishes.
Woo! With a nice runner. Unbelievable. What a shot. Wow. What an exciting game.
25-23. Uh-oh. Tried to play with it. It did not happen.
The steal, the long court pass.
Stolen back by Kizart.
Oh, it's stolen. Oh, nice no-look pass to Taylor Toney.
And she finishes.
Should have been an and one on that. This is a close game right now, 25-23, Team Faith. Woo, the crossover from Lyric Williams.
Adams with the
ball. Kayla Adams with the ball. Going to the cup. She still got it. Going up strong.
Nice finish.
Can't take it away. That girl is strong. What a beast. Inside. Team Truth is holding on. Raven DuBois. Taylor Toney with the drive.
Had to be a foul on that play. Taylor Toney will be at the line shooting too. Like the pace so far in the second half.
Oh, this pace is amazing. It's kind of hard to keep up with. I mean, so much has happened in just 4 minutes.
Going up and down.
The replay right there, but great pass by Kizer to Taylor Toney underneath.
So Tony's at the line shooting too. Knocks down the first one. 3-point lead for Team Faith. 15, about 16 minutes left to go in the game.
What an
Lexi Lee checking back in for Team Faith.
Well, you know, I'm just kind of thinking about it. Tanisha Scott is up now talking to her players. You know, this is a conference rival right here. Minneapolis South versus Minneapolis North. Coaches, do you think that has anything to do with the intensity of this game?
Well, probably not, because I think it's about these girls around here, and they're just competing. They're out here having a good time. Nice move.
Oh, Lyric Williams.
She's like, where is the call?
You guys don't understand. My destination is at Virginia. Yep. I'm trying to show you guys. I got a little game. That's right. She is all about business. Well, got to work on the free throws just a little bit.
Yeah, got to get that up there.
But all the energy on that move right there, you know, you got to kind of take a deep breath.
And the second one, bounces out.
Daryl Lipscomb almost got away from getting another rebound. But she's determined to get her average.
She is a beast on the boards.
Wow, unbelievable. Kizer brings the ball up once again.
Yeah, she is doing a very good job handling the point guard.
Oh, nice drive to the basket with the left finger roll.
Nice finish by
unbelievable.
Chelsea Kizer out of St. Paul Central
and finish. Wow.
Lyric Williams. You know, I was confused because St. Paul Central had a point guard last year named Lyric Williams.
Nice putback.
Another Adams.
Kayla
bucket.
Adams.
Another Adams
rebound.
Bucket. Looks like Adams is trying to run away with that MVP trophy.
DuBois with a nice move. Oh my God.
Raven DuBois.
Nice. Now that's fundamental basketball at its best. What a nice move.
She's a problem. She's a problem. She is
Lyric
a problem.
Williams. Oh my God. She has got her handles under control.
She's a problem.
Unbelievable.
Right now.
Taylor Toney, right back at ya.
Right back at ya.
Gotta get back down on defense. That transition game is one of the most fundamental things about basketball. You gotta be able to get back. Kayla Adams with the ball. Thinks about it. Bulldozes her way.
Sister. Finish in there. Oh, no, didn't go.
Nice box out by Kayla Adams. Unbelievable. She held her out.
Yes, she did.
Unbelievable.
Nice block out.
Wow. Taylor Toney was there, but she didn't have a chance. Unbelievable. These girls, when they're determined, they can play some basketball. I tell you, isn't it something? Isn't it amazing?
Yeah,
it is so fun to watch girls basketball. You see the fundamentals, you see the toughness.
Yeah.
And you see the fight and determination.
Yes.
Girls basketball is so exciting to watch. Once again, she's going to the College of North Dakota State College of Science, a Division I junior college. Second free throw is
next. One for two.
Good.
The line.
Taylor Toney with the rebound.
Maybe.
Boy, I didn't even know that they're pressing in this game. Taylor Toney is upset. Got the ball taken away from the double team.
Yeah,
didn't expect the press.
Yeah, I didn't understand why she didn't pass the ball to her wide open point guard that was back over there. Cost her a turnover.
Unbelievable.
With Lyric Williams back at the line shooting too.
And like I said, this game is extremely competitive. This is like a run and jump press. they both just decided, they said, you know what? We want to win this game.
Yes, sir.
Team Faith still has an advantage of 3 points, 34-31.
Now they got the ball back into the person's hands that can control it then. She's up shooting two.
The versatility, I tell you, of Kizer. She put the ball there in her right hand, which means, you know, she's comfortable both with both her left and her right hand.
She did a great job there going to the basket.
Yes, very impressive.
And she's doing a good job of picking her spots and when to go to the basket, when to move the ball. Doing a good job of controlling things. That'll be a nice point guard for a school next year.
Actually, it's Lawrence Smith. My apologies on that. They jumped to the basket. From Johnson.
Oh, that's Lawrence Smith, yes. Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's my bad there. Very versatile player.
Good defense there by
Emma Shepherd from Washburn.
Aaliyah Curtis Evans was playing some great defense there a minute ago.
Lyric Williams, did you see that shot? I mean, she's got that one-hand shot. That is her deal. That is her signature.
Wow.
Crystal Flint, those that don't know, used to be an official. I'm not sure if she can still be a head coach and an official at the same time. So this is going to be kind of interesting.
She is making sure that Pat Rock, the official, get in position to make a call.
I'm not sure if that's a fair advantage right
there. She doesn't want Pat down up here at half court making calls. That's too funny.
Kayla Adams goes to work. She's determined to get to the basket.
Oh,
Kayla.
To the basket.
Oh, Kayla Adams said, hey, you are not stopping me. She's trying to get that MVP.
Raven.
It's going to be really interesting as to who finishes that, gets that eight.
Lexi MVP. Lee for three did not go.
The defense, Lexi Lee with the rebound.
Oh,
the
nice move.
Crossover. Cross. The pass.
Back to Kizer.
Woo, Kizer is so cat quick.
Oh.
Great defense by Kayla Adams, the block. Drives to the basket. They're struggling
Uh-oh.
For it.
Kayla Adams to Kizer.
Nice pass.
Down there cherry picking by herself. 37-33.
We got about 9 minutes left to go. This is a close game. I don't know. What are your thoughts?
You know, I think that they're going to continue to play hard all the way to the end. So I don't know who's going to win the ball game. They're going to play hard right to the end.
That was a nice pass by Lyric Williams to
Emma Shepherd.
Washburn.
Knocks it down. Kizer is putting it. Oh, a little bit too much English on that. Curtessa Scott to the basket.
But the runner of her own. With the runner of her own.
Tied the game up at 37.
Wow. 8 minutes left to go. The nice drive. Oh, what a fundamental move. Oh, just short.
Lee just for short three.
Aaliyah Sigil. The shot from Raven DuBois was short.
Williams got the.
They're looking to push the floor. Kayla.
Nice finish.
Adams with the finish. And we got a timeout.
39-37. Team Truth took the lead.
Team Faith is not playing around. She said timeout, baby.
Team Truth has just went on an 8-0 run.
Wow.
She needed a timeout there.
Very
39-37 is your score.
And I'm kind of thinking ever since, you know, Coach Flint, you know, addressed the officials, yeah, there might have been a little swing here.
She just wanted him to be in a proper position. Being that Crystal Flint is also a high school and college official, along with being a high school basketball coach.
Sounds like she's pretty busy.
Yes.
Wow, what an exciting second half with about 8 minutes, a little over 8 minutes to go. And both coaches are, you know, giving their teams the prep talk, and the kids look, they're getting their water and they're getting rejuvenated for this next run of the next 8 minutes. It could be anyone's game. Team Faith is, they held the lead, my God, for most of the second half and to this particular point.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. So, yeah, 39-37 in favor of Team Truth has taken a lead with the run they just went on there behind Miss Adams and Miss Williams.
This should be exciting.
Also, Miss Shepherd, Emma Shepherd, also had a couple of nice plays in that run. Lexi Lee from Maranatha brings the ball up the court. Passes over to Kizart. Nice cross court pass to Tony, and Tony is fouled. Tony was fouled. On the shot.
Here, Tony.
The referees are consulting with the coach to see if there was a on the pass or on the shot.
Taylor Toney going to UIC, University of Illinois Chicago.
She'll be shooting two. And she makes the first, missed the second.
It's a 1-point game. Free throws, how important are free throws?
Nice stutter step.
Oh my God, Dario Lipsko with a block from Taylor Toney. Tries to split the middle, gets that pass off some kind of way.
Alexis Hughes will have the ball. Now Kizart has it.
Kizart to the basket.
Oh.
Just short. Taylor Toney with the steal.
Oh, nice.
Goes up strong. Oh, misses the lay-in.
Kizart with the rebound. Little guard goes in there and gets the rebound.
Unbelievable. Oh, got hit in the face with the ball there. Unbelievable. Lauren Smith with the ball. Taylor Toney for three. Just short.
No good.
Lipscomb once again with the rebound. No surprise.
Lipscomb, nice pass to Shepherd. Oh, Shepherd.
Ball's short.
Has a bad angle there. Oh,
the block.
Look at Kizart with the block.
Unbelievable. Nice
Kizart
block.
Kizart with the block.
And the finish. Wow, what a play. She gives Team Faith the lead. I tell you, if Team Faith, you know, if they win, she might be,
You know, Kizart really has been the MVP.
Wow.
I mean, she's been doing it all, but it usually goes on to scoring the most. I don't think she has the most points, but she's been playing an excellent floor game.
Lexi
Lee! The first
Lee.
Three-pointer of the game is good for Lexi
you
Lee.
You can hear the net from here. That's unbelievable.
That's the nicest sound in sports right there. The net popping
yes,
like
it
that.
Is.
And that's Renikoff from Washburn.
Hey.
Team Faith takes the lead back to 43-41.
They are hyped up. Unbelievable. 5 minutes left to go. We got another time. How many timeouts do you get in an All-Star game?
Probably as many as you want.
I was just wondering.
I don't think that anybody's keeping track of anything down there.
I was wondering because there's been a few timeouts caught in this game.
43-41. Team Faith is taking back the lead.
We got a pretty decent crowd today.
Under six to go.
No nice weather.
People still fouling in. What a beautiful day.
Yeah, absolutely.
That young man enjoying some funyuns.
And so this is exciting. That makes me feel pretty good that, you know, you got a good crowd with a good weather. That says a lot about Intercity All-Star Classic.
It does. It does. Really a good day for it. Maya Johnson.
Yeah, we got how many minutes left we got in this game? We got about 5 minutes left.
About five to go. Lexi Lee with the ball.
It's anyone's game.
For three again. Oh, I thought she was going to do a Steph Curry. Just throw one up and it goes in. Lyric Williams. What's she gonna do here? Oh, and she finishes right by Kizart. Lyric Williams. Too high. Tie game at 43.
Oh my goodness. It could go down to the wire here. It might be a last second shot.
Clock is
Lyric Williams
back again.
Brings the ball up. She looks like she's going coast to coast. I'm not sure about you. She looked like she's on a mission right now. I don't know if she's going to give that up.
She's passing inside. Nope.
Okay, she looks like she wants it back. She wants it back.
Tony
but the steal from Taylor, Tony.
There's a lot of contact out there
steal.
Right now.
Back-to-back steals. And it's, end one. What a move.
Nice play by Chelsea Cazard.
My point guard of the day.
She is having one heck of a ball game.
In the building. What a shot. Unbelievable.
She'll be shooting one. Her baby face. She looks so young.
What a tough athlete. What a tough athlete. I tell you what, I'm not sure who's going to pick her up after, but she definitely has the potential to continue playing
she
at the
can
next level.
Definitely run somebody's show.
Unbelievable. Derek Williams. Team Faith back up by three with 4 minutes left to go.
Miss Adams, gets the ball stripped from her by Tony.
When she goes to the basket, I mean, you got to watch. She looks like LeBron James going through there. I mean, you know, it's like, get out of the way.
Get out of the way, for real.
Exactly. Speaking of that, what's your choice for tonight?
You know, LeBron is so great, but they're so beat up. I mean, you look at it, you know, in the history of the game, imagine Michael Jordan and his, just as great as he was, but imagine him losing his top two players in any of his championships. Yeah. You know, they're expecting, you know, people are expecting LeBron to get it done. Think about Jordan without, say, Pippen and Rodman or Pippen and whoever in any of those championships. It wouldn't have happened. So.
Dario Lipscomb with the rebound. Did you see that?
She
the
is a
work
beast.
Ethic? Oh, my God. She was. Did you see how much she just continued to go at that? That is so hard to teach. Unbelievable. She's got a natural gift, I tell you. It's amazing.
Nice. Adams inches foul.
Like I said, LeBron James. We were just talking about that.
Taking over.
She has the determination to get to the basket and, like I said, get out the way. But you're right. LeBron James, he's playing. He's undermanned. And I tell you, my hat's off. This is the first time I became a LeBron James fan this year watching him play.
Yeah, I've always been a fan of his. Just the way he is playing so unselfishly when he doesn't have to. You know, a player of his skill could take every shot, every game, and no one will say anything about it. But for him to share the ball the way he does and to play a good floor game the way he does, both into the court.
Well, did you know who started that? Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan started that. He was one to talk about. Taylor Toney.
Finish.
Unbelievable. Keeping Team Faith alive. 4 minutes left to go.
48-44. Team Faith is winning. Lyric likes about turning the ball over, and she does not turn it over. A three. Another three.
Unbelievable.
Lucia Rinnikoff.
She didn't touch nothing but the net. Unbelievable.
Minneapolis Conference Player of the Year.
Wow, I can see why.
Cazard.
I can see why.
Williams had a rebound, lost it. Gets the
Daria Lipscomb with the rebound.
What about her 39th rebound?
She's going to the basket.
Throws it up. It does not go in.
The rebound.
Adams.
Oh, my God. The rebound by the female LeBron James. What can we say? Kayla Adams. She is the female LeBron James out here. Going to the basket.
She is definitely strong. Very unstoppable when she's going to that basket. She's going to get fouled or get a shot off. She missed the free throw. 48-47. We have subs coming in the game. Coming back in the game, Lauren Smith. Also, Raven Dubois.
If she makes this free throw, we have a tied game with 3 minutes left to go.
Aaliyah Curtis-Evans also checking back in, all for Team Faith. And if she makes a free throw, and she does not.
Dario Lipscomb with the rebound.
With her 40th rebound.
Unbelievable.
But Lyric Williams.
Unbelievable.
Again.
And she shows the muscles. Oh, my God. You know, before that basket, I was going to say, we got a Cherry Warriors show here. The Twins play for Cherry Warriors. Dario Lipscomb play for Cherry Warriors. Dario Lipscomb, another rebound. I don't know how many she has at this point.
You know what?
But there should have been a rebounding award today.
But if there's a word called everyone, I think that's what she has. Every single rebound that's coming out.
Unbelievable.
The pass. Nice pick and roll.
The hands. Nice pass.
Nice pass. Lauren Smith to the basket. Oh, she throws it away. She should have finished it.
Team Truth up by 1:44. It could be anyone's game.
It is anyone's game. 49-48. Under 3 minutes to go.
Lyric Williams brings the ball up. She's like, you know, hey, listen, we're gonna spread the floor out a little bit. Get open.
Let's go. Set a screen. There she goes. Lyric Williams. She's open.
The runner.
And she knocks it down.
I told you, Lyric Williams. They just cleared it out for him. Unbelievable. The drive to the back. Oh, what a steal. What a steal by Shepherd of Washburn.
Uh-oh, Renikoff with the ball. Back to Lyric Williams.
Lyric Williams goes to the basket.
Again. Well, somebody put a body on her.
Oh, my God. Hey, Lyric Williams. She said, I want the MVP. Want the MVP. Lyric Williams with the rebound. She's going. Uh-oh. You got Kayla Adams for three. Just short. Team Faith better come on. They're down by five. It's a minute and a half to go. Team Faith looks like they're running out of energy.
They got to make some subs here to get their power back in.
Team Faith looks like they're running out of a little faith here. And that is the truth.
That is the truth, that they're out of faith. But it is not over.
It is not over.
Because they put Kazard back in the game. They went on that run with Kazard on the bench.
Wow.
And that's the difference. You can't take her out the game with... Oh, she almost knocked the three down, which brought him right back in the game.
A nice steal.
Raven Dubois.
And the finish.
And look at it. Now, if she makes a free throw, it's right back to a two-point game.
With a minute, 13 seconds left to go. What a play. What a defensive effort. What a great defensive effort right there. Unbelievable. See the miss right here. But the effort right here from Kyla.
Nice head fake.
Adams.
And she does make the three-point play to make it a two-point game.
And they got the press with the steal. Unbelievable.
Oh, but she gave it back. Raven
wasn't ready for it. She wasn't ready for it. Oh, my God. She wasn't ready for it. You got a two-point game. They got a run and jump press going. LeBron James in the middle.
3 seconds in there.
They're going to call her for it this time. Oh, my God.
She's
unbelievable.
I was wondering how long they were going to let her be in the lane.
This is the first time I've ever seen this call in an All-Star game. I didn't know they could call 3 seconds.
She was camping. I got to give them that. She was in there for about 20.
The two-point game.
Oh.
The nice pass. Oh. We got a foul.
Called.
The officials look like they're going to talk.
The toughest thing to do is the ref in All-Star game, because you don't know, you're calling the game loose, and then when it counts, you want to call it, and then by that time.
Now, I don't know if it's you, but it looked like they're doing a rock, paper, scissors between the officials here to determine whether or not that was a shooting foul or not. Wow. She got two shots. Unbelievable. Rock, paper, scissors.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Crystal Flint is... extremely upset.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Being a state tournament official,
exactly.
She's like, you can't do this.
Yep. Been around basketball for about 30 years now, coaching for over 20, and I've never seen that.
Well, she misses the first.
Never ever seen that.
She misses the first free throw on that, so.
I think that actually played into Team Truth's hands to have her shooting free throws rather than them get the ball back and have a chance to have Kuzart with the ball able to create.
Well, Lexi Lee comes back in. That's their three-point shooter. Along with Taylor Toney.
It's a one-point game, another timeout.
With 40 seconds left. So, what's the strategy? Do you pick up full court? Do you press? Do you play man-to-man?
I get the ball out of Lyric Williams' hands any way possible.
Absolutely. That's right. She's bringing the ball up and doing whatever she wants to do when she brings it up.
You get the ball out of her hands and close out on whoever else gets the shot. That's all you can really do.
And hopefully, Daria Lipscomb, I don't know if she's in the game or not, but you better box her out.
Oh, no doubt.
The state's leading rebounder, you have got to box her out.
Yeah, I don't know if that's possible. I don't think it's possible. I haven't seen it yet today. I don't think it's going to happen.
Do you think we're going to get a foul here, though? You know, Team Faith, actually, they're not, or Team Truth is not in the...
I believe that you're right. What I think is going to happen is it's going to be a foul around the basket. Someone's going to get fouled around the basket. That's my prediction.
Okay.
They
look like they're picking up full court, so looks like they are matched up man-to-man here. And full court man-to-man.
I'm surprised that, they can just throw it over the top. They got nobody back.
They're face guarding, which is, there you go. They finally got something off the ball.
They had nobody back.
That's right. You talked about that. They almost had it.
It. Your eyes light up as a coach, you see that. It's like, what? You give us a layup?
Exactly.
Yep.
Oh, my God. Off of Lyric Williams, we got a steal. What a play. What a turn of events right now.
Still plenty of time. 30, 40 seconds to go.
Raven Dubois is going to inbound the ball.
Get the Kazart.
The defense by
Lyric Williams.
Taylor Toney.
The
three-point game. There's still time.
Still plenty of time.
There's still plenty of time.
Lyric Williams has stolen the MVP.
Oh, she puts in too hard. Full court pass. Adams against her sister.
And she finishes it.
Unbelievable. 18 seconds left to go. And Team Faith looks like they need a three at this point. Good defense.
They need a
There's
three.
7 seconds left to go.
They need a three badly and no good.
Oh, my
and
God.
It's fitting that she gets the last rebound.
Wow. That's right.
Yeah, she deserves
Dario Lipscomb with the last rebound. Absolutely.
And 57-52 in truth is better than faith today.
Oh, and that hurts, man. That hurts. That hurts. Yeah. Hurt me deep right there. I tell you, what a great game, though. Congratulations to both teams. Girls played well.
You know, we need to get Lyric Williams over here for an interview here.
Well,
because it'll be a travesty if she doesn't get MVP.
Well, I tell you, so before we do that, Kayla Adams had a great second half as well.
She also had a very good game.
And I tell you, the rebounding effort of Dario Lipscomb could have been the difference of the game. So it's going to be a tough choice there.
Yeah, you know, you're right. But for my money, Lyric Williams basically turned that game around when they were down, and she pulled that game out, you know, with her, you know, isolation plays and getting to the basket and scoring. So she did a great job with that. But all the girls, like you said, played hard. I mean, it wasn't like she did it by herself. I mean, her teammates,
right.
You know, Dario Lipscomb with the rebounding and Kayla Adams with the inside play. There was a total team effort there. Also, Renikoff hit the big three. Also, Emma Shepherd had a big bucket in there.
It was a great second half, I tell you. Both teams, the effort that they came out with and the energy was amazing. And once again, girls basketball is really exciting. And it's growing so much in the state of Minnesota. I'm proud to live here. I'm proud to be a coach here in the state of Minnesota, to be able to coach the upcoming great athletes that we have here today. So this was a great game.
Yes, it was. It was a very fun game.
I think, do we have an MVP yet?
I believe they're about going to announce the MVP. They're in the crowd right now. And
I got to go to this open house. So I just wanted to say hi.
He was going in open house. That was over the air.
Well,
Mr. Adams.
So, yes.
The MVP is...
We're about to announce that right now.
It's about to be announced right now.
Wow. Unbelievable. by Lyric Williams.
Lyric Williams put on an absolute show. And like you said, she only beat her teammate by 1 point.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
So, yeah, unbelievable.
Yes, that was unbelievable, I tell you. And that's what I was talking about. You know, at the beginning of the game, you can tell she set the tone. She said at the very beginning.
Yep.
And she was on a mission.
And she left here with both awards today. You know, she came home, she came in, she did her thing.
And that's what's so exciting. You know, I tell these seniors when I've coached the All-Star game, you know, this is your opportunity to show Minnesota before you leave here, really, you know, who you are.
Yes, no
and
doubt.
And she did that. She definitely did that. If you didn't know who Lyric Williams was, you definitely walked away today knowing who is.
Yeah, she was definitely the most dominant player today out there on that court.
Be great to get her over for an interview.
So we're going to get her to come over here for an interview. So Lyric Williams out of Armstrong High School. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Hey, so now when you woke up this morning, were you thinking MVP?
I already had, like, I don't know, I just want to get the ball and then get it back. So, like, I looked to pass first, and then after that, I just, if I'm fulfilling it, I'm shooting it, or I'm going to the lane or to the hole, so.
You know, what I saw of your game is I saw how poised you were, you know, in your isolation sets, you know, picking your spots, knowing where to go, where to get to, how to get to the basket bucket. Was your high school coach, did he demand that of you throughout the season?
Yeah, he just told me to find my gaps because I do a good job of, like, finding the gap and going to the lane and finishing strong. He's like, find your gaps. If not, kick it out to your shooters and know your role and play it. So that's what I just kind of did, just know my role like he told me and play it. So that's basically what I did. So
now you are the MVP, the 22nd MVP of this game. This award is named after this young lady behind you, Tamara Moore. She was the first MVP. Have you had an opportunity to see any of these games in the past and watch some of the MVPs of the past?
Yeah, I watched Kenesha Bell a lot when she was playing. I like her style of play. She likes to drop dimes. She's a really good basketball player, good ball handling, and I like that about her. So I watched her a lot, and I've watched the game before and everything, and I was just like, well, I know how to get the ball in the hole, so that's my goal, to get the ball in the hole and try to help my team win. That's what I've tried to do for the past 4 years at Armstrong. So that's what I did today, and I did it well. So
Faith Johnson wants to ask you a question. Go ahead, Faith.
When you started the game, we could tell, we were talking about, we could see that you were on a mission. What were you thinking, and how did you prepare and warm up for this game mentally?
Well, every time I get ready to play, I'm laughing or giggling. I'm always focused and having my mind set on something is trying to win. I'm very competitive. I have a very big love for the game, so I take it serious. So my mind was just trying to get the ball in the hole, trying to win, and try to stay competitive and make the right decisions and passes and kind of take care of the ball and just teamwork. Without the help of the All-Star team, I wouldn't even have got this trophy or without God. So I'm very blessed with the talent that I have, and I just use it, try to work as hard as possible. And, yeah.
Awesome, awesome. So you're going to Johnson County next year?
Yeah, I'm going to Johnson County.
Now, I heard possibly Virginia after that.
I had a lot of D1 interest. I had, like, Alabama, Virginia, all of them, but my ACT wasn't cutting it. But, yeah, I don't know about Virginia. I don't know where yet. KU and Missouri are going to try to get me first, so whichever one fits me offensively-wise, and I'm going to grow as a player, so I don't know where I'll try to go after that. But
now, we were... Coach Johnson here was basically saying that she would advocate for you to be here at the University of Minnesota.
Me and Coach Mo talked. He was the one that told me to go to Johnson County. Uh-huh. So he didn't tell me he wanted me, but he called me up and told me that how good of a, he said, we recruit there and everything. And he said, keep my number. If ever you need anything, just call me. So I don't know if he wants me to go there or not, if he's trying to recruit me after 2 years. I don't know, but it is all my family live out here, and that's an option that I would take. So I want everybody to come see me play, and majority of my family's in Minnesota, so.
Well, we as Gopher fans hope that it works out that way because you're a one heck of a player. And congratulations today, and good luck in your future.
Thank you.
Take a look at that trophy. Lyric Williams, MVP, 22nd annual MVP, Inner City All-Star Classic. Thank you, Lyric.
Thank you.
So what do you think about her game, Faith?
Wow, first of all, listening to her, what an IQ.
Yeah.
I mean, what a player. I mean, what I loved about her, she said, I'm going to continue to get better.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
And you know, she is. And you can just tell she's on a mission. She's serious. She's focused.
Yes.
You know, I love her. I love her game. And,
yes.
And she, you know, when they get stronger, especially at the next level, they have an opportunity to work out differently and then play against tougher competition consistently.
Yes.
She is going to be one heck of a player, and I definitely will be talking to the Gophers about her.
Yes, and I think that the probably the weakness in her game from what I saw is she's going to have to, and she can get better at, and that's the outside shot, you know, being able to shoot the ball from 19 to 20. I didn't see that in her game, which she's going to have to develop. But otherwise, man, she was strong with the ball. She was quick. She could handle the ball with both hands. She had good instincts. I mean, she's gonna be a very good player. And like you said, her IQ is off the charts. It's interesting to see what's gonna happen with her in her future.
Yeah.
So, what do you think about that? Well, you know, we enjoyed that first game. We have to sign off here and get ready for the second game. Of the evening, the boys game. So with that, for Faith Johnson Patterson, this is Troy Russell, and thank you for watching the 22nd annual Inner City All-Star Classic Girls Basketball Game.